ISUPK.
All I'm going to tell you, man, if you want to stay plugged in and tuned in, make sure you subscribe to ISUPK on YouTube. A lot of powerful information will be coming out this summer, and you want to stay tuned in. The minute they drop it, it's coming right to you, baby, as soon as you subscribe. So make sure you handle that business and subscribe to ISUPK.
And killed for his children, man.
That's right.
For the children that he favored and loved, black man. And Hispanic, go ahead.
Exodus chapter 23, verse 22. If thou shalt indeed obey his voice.
You gotta obey the Most High first, man. We not obeying the Most High. We not obeying the Most High being homosexual, man. We not obeying the Most High choosing to marry a white woman over a beautiful black woman.
Right.
We not obeying the Most High, but we want to fight our brother and smile in our enemy's face, who is the white man. Go in.
And do all that I speak.
And we got to do all that he speaks. You read this Bible right here. The Bible got law, and he got commandments. And what you got to know is this. The Lord's commandments is not grievous. Not grievous at all. You know, what does that mean? The Lord has different laws and commandments. I'll explain a few. I'll be brief with it. The Lord said don't eat pork, crabs, or lobster. Pork is the one that's given us high blood pressure in the black community. It's no secret.
Right.
Some of us got to get our legs amputated. AIDS. Black people, we were the highest people in America that had AIDS, right? Through what? Most of the time it's homosexuality. But what if I told you that God said homosexuality is an abomination? What if none of us is homosexual? That AIDS would not be in the community, man. It wouldn't be there. It wouldn't be such a big number. We gotta get back to obeying our Father. Reason to talk to you, sir.
But if thou shalt indeed obey his voice and do all that I speak, then I will be an enemy unto thine enemy.
And the Lord said he will be an enemy to your enemies, man. You never seen a forest fire? You haven't seen recently when the Lord had burnt California? That was done by angels. Any earthquake, hurricane, forest fires, anything, it's not Mother Nature. Any floods? All these floods, it's just not Mother Nature or a natural disaster.
Right.
That is done by the work of God.
That's
that is done by his angels, man.
That's
his
right.
Angels go to war. His angels go to war on his command. Go ahead, go ahead.
And an adversary unto thine adversary.
Listen, man, what this scripture is simply saying is what this scripture simply says is this. Black man, you are oppressed. You have an enemy, and we don't recognize our enemy. That's why we continue to fail every year, and we have to continue to fail for decades in a century, man. But if you obey your father, he will bring fire to America. He will put the white man under your boot.
That's right.
That's what you have to understand, man. Give me Exodus 15:3. We gotta understand the character of God. Because the Christian church and weak pastors and weak leaders who are greedy for our money have perverted the character of God and made God and Christ seem like punks, man. Which make us punks, man.
Right.
Go ahead.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. The Lord is a man of war.
The Lord is what?
A man of war.
I thought the Lord was soft and loved everybody. I thought God wouldn't hurt a fly. The Lord is what?
The Lord is a man of war.
It said God is a man of war, man. So what is your pastor talking about when he say God don't kill anything? God wouldn't hurt a fly. God don't hate. Your pastor is deceiving you.
That's right.
Your pastor just wants your money, man.
Right.
And your pastor is making all of us black men, making all of us soft. All of us as black men together as a whole are walking around with our tail tucked in between our legs because of the philosophy, man. We have become victims to America. So black man, you are much stronger than that, man. You are a warrior, black man. Is it any secret? Is it any secret that the black and Hispanic is number one in boxing and UFC and fighting and the NFL and NBA? Nah. But that strength, that agility and power was used for war at one time. And black man, it will be used for war again under the command of a black man and Jesus Christ, man. We're gonna read about different times when we were not scared and we stood with the Lord. And the Lord showed his power, man. Give me Daniel chapter 3, man, verse 1. Today we're gonna read about different events and times when we stood with God and he helped us conquer our enemy. That's what the pastor doesn't read about. If the pastor would read about how when we stood with the Lord and the Lord defeated and killed our enemy, black people would be better today. And we would know who to turn to. I was watching a video on Facebook, and it was a black man. He wore those sweater vests like Carlton from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. He wore those sweater vests, and he had his sons wear the vest. He had his sons wear certain colors, and he would not have his sons wear hoodies because of Trayvon Martin. This black man was afraid for his two sons. He did not want his sons to be killed by police. So in his mind, he's trying to figure out a way, like all of us. We always, black people, Hispanics, we always try to figure out a way to survive in America. Because we know America is scary for black people. We know America is dangerous for Hispanics, right? Look at our Hispanic brothers right now in the detention centers dealing with ICE. We know that America is dangerous for us. So we try to find ways to survive. We try to change our voice. We try to shave our head and shave our face bald. We try to say, what can we do to appease this beast? What can we do to make the white man happy? That's what all of us as black people say. That's what my grandmama told me. And that's what your grandmama told you. She said, boy, cut your hair low. She said, boy, don't go that big. Am I telling a lie? Did your grandmother not tell you that? Did your grandmother say, boy, wear this and wear that? See, your grandmother wanted you to always look professional in America so you would not cause any trouble at all. And what we don't understand is our parents have been doing that since slavery to protect us from the evil white man, from the slave master, man. But what they missed out on, that tactic will never work. What we gotta understand is the white man is a beast. He is a snarling animal and a beast.
Absolutely.
And he will continue to devour us every day. It don't matter if we dye our hair blonde. It doesn't matter if we shave our beard. It don't matter if we make our voice lighter. And it does not matter if you smile at him every day. He will hate you forever, man. And I will show you that scripture in the Bible. Give me Daniel chapter 3, verse. Go ahead. First of all, keep your thumb and let's get Ezekiel 35. That's how the white man will hate us forever. So us as black people and Hispanics will know how to deal with this beast and know that we have an enemy. Go ahead.
Ezekiel chapter 35, verse 5. because thou hast had a perpetual hatred.
A what?
Perpetual hatred.
Does anybody know what perpetual means? No, perpetual hatred. Perpetual, it means, there you go. Continual, there you go, bro. Yeah, both of y'all brothers got a point. It means forever, a continual reason of something, sir.
Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has shed the blood of the children of Israel.
And who's the children of Israel? You black man, you Hispanic man. The Bible been talking about the white man. The Bible has always talked about him having a perpetual hatred against us and shedding our blood. He been shedding our blood before slavery. He been shedding our blood when he was a Roman, when he was Greek, Alexander the so-called great, when he Alexander the Greek. He been hating us before then. Go ahead.
And has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword.
By the force of the sword. What's the sword today? Pull over. Pull over. And all of a sudden, the police draw his gun and shoot us. The police and the police don't even give a damn if it's a black woman, an old black woman, a young black kid. The police don't give a damn, man. These racist cops don't care. These white people don't care, man. It's because the Bible said they will have a forever, a continual hatred for us, man. Go ahead.
In the time of their calamity, in the time that their iniquity had an end.
What is that iniquity? The iniquity is the punishment that was put on black people. Black man, I may or may not blow your mind, but what if I was to tell you that slavery could have never happened? What if I told you that slavery, that we could have dodged going through slavery? How could we have done that? We could have done that by following the laws of God. By doing what, brother? Get that brother a hand, man. He on point. He on point, man. The brother said we could have dodged slavery by obeying his commandments. You think I'm lying? Let's get Deuteronomy 28. First of all, let's finish that off real quick. Then we're going to get when God said, I will put you in slavery if you do not obey my voice. He said, I will let a fierce nation, come and conquer you if you do not obey my voice, man. Go ahead.
Therefore, as I live, said the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood.
The Lord said he's going to prepare the white man unto blood because he has always had a continual hatred. And it said, and earlier the scripture said, even when our iniquity had an end. That iniquity was that punishment, that 400 years of slavery. Right now we have served our punishment and it's supposed to be over. But we're still going through hell today by the white man, right?
Right.
Give me Deuteronomy 21, and then let's get 69. We're going to read what Moses said when the Lord told Moses to tell the people, if they obey me today, the Lord said, I'm going to make black people kings and rule the earth. But if they don't, I'm going to make them slaves. I'm going to make them slaves because they my children, and my children are my hard-headed children. Are not listening to me, so they must be punished.
Right.
28:1. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 28:1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
It said hearken diligently. We got to listen and be diligent to the laws. We got to make sure we don't break the laws of God. Go ahead. If we do that, what?
To observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Wait a minute. Whoa. Read that again. The Lord, hold on, wait a minute. I thought God, the pastor said, we equal everybody. I thought God loved everybody. Why would God choose sides and make a certain people higher or superior than the other? Read that again. The Lord would do what?
The Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Amen. You got every black man, you got a Bible at home that's collected dust. Blow that dust off that Bible and open up the Bible, man. Because your pastor's nice doing this. And this is not a trick Bible. We ain't get this from the magic shop. This is a regular old King James Version Bible. It has no tricks. Go read Deuteronomy chapter 28. And you're going to see when a certain people, if they obey God, they will do what?
Set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Above all nations of the earth. Why? Because there's other nations. You got the East Indian nation. You got the evil white nation. You got the Arab nation. You got some African nations. The Lord said you were going to rule. And at times we were. At times we were rulers. And then when we broke the laws of God, the Lord brought us low. See, this says sets you above high. Right now, we're black people at? We low right now. We nowhere near high. But guess what? Today, the reason the prophets are out here, we're not just here in D.C. We're in Baltimore, New York, Chicago. We're in Texas, the U.K.
Right.
We're in California. We're everywhere speaking today, right now.
Right.
We're waking up everybody right now, man. Check us out on YouTube. All right, go to YouTube, type in IHGBK, man.
That's right.
You're going to see us everywhere, man.
I know the sheep can wake up to y'all.
That's right, man.
Hey, ain't no
we teaching. That's what's up there, Prophet Ann.
Yeah, I know the sheep can wake up to y'all.
We teaching all over to wake our people up. Why? Because we are tired of the oppression that we're going through, man. And we have tried every single thing. We tried to follow Dr. King and go march and hold signs. That ain't work. It ain't going to work. We try to be violent, like the Black Panthers. You cannot be violent. The white man is the one that's making the guns. How you gonna try to fight him with his own power? You gotta fight him with a supernatural power, man.
That's right.
A superior power.
That's right.
The only power is the one that the living God that shakes the earth, man.
That's right.
That is the only one, man. And Christians always love to say, if God is with you, then who can be against you? But they never consider, what if God is not with you, then what? If God is not with you, then his face is turned from you. And right now, the Lord, our Father, he's turned from his children. We are his children, and his face is turned from us, black man.
Right.
It don't matter what we do, the violence or the non-violence. What we got to do is obey our Father. Obey our Father, and he'll let you back in the house. You ever got put out by your father or your mother?
Okay.
I got put out by my father. I was like probably like 20-21. Huh. And my heart was broken.
Right.
But once I came back to my senses and straightened up, I was for sure let back in, man. For sure. Your parents will they'll let you come back around once you straighten up, man. And what black people, Hispanic people got to do as a whole is obey the Father. If you obey my commandments, I will set you above high. But right now we are low. Give me 15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
So this is what black people are going through today. This is what Hispanics are going through today. Go ahead.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So this one says, if you do not listen to the, if you do not listen to God, if you do not obey his commandments, then what?
To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses,
all these what?
Curses.
All these what?
Curses.
The crack epidemic.
Curses.
AIDS and HIV.
Curses.
High blood pressure, diabetes.
Curses.
Black violence.
Curses.
Police brutality.
Curses.
Being poor and sleeping on the streets.
Curses.
All these what?
Curses shall come upon thee.
All these curses shall come upon you. Go ahead.
And overtake thee.
And overtake you. We are overtaken with curses, black man. We don't realize we are already burnt up. We already living in hell. It ain't gonna get no hotter than being strung out on crack. It ain't gonna get no hotter than being killed by a hot bullet from a racist cop, man. We're not gonna die and go to hell. We living in hell right damn now, black man. Hell is a condition on earth. If black people are living in hell, then who the hell is living in heaven? The white man. Because guess what? Black man, you get pulled over by the cops. All right, brother, have a good one. You stay up, bro. Black man, you get pulled over by the cops. It's a different story from when a white man get pulled over. A white man get pulled over, he can talk all the trash to the white man. He can jump up in the white man's face. He damn near can try to take the white man's gun, and the white man still ain't gonna shoot him. Black man, you blink, and a white man quick draw wrong. You blink wrong. He wanna draw on you. The white man is a devil, man.
That's right.
And right now, black man, we are living in the hell. The ISUBK, we have been taught by men above us, Commander Junior Hanna and the men that taught him. We have been given something special. We have been given the only key and the only wisdom to get us up out of this hell. And the key is to fear God. That's it, man. Because if you fear God, you won't disobey his voice.